What's up YouTube, this is your host Emmanuel from smartflowers.com. Welcome back to another tutorial of WordPress. After I make my thumbnail images from Elementor, I quickly add a widget and I'm gonna select a blank widget and I'm gonna go for plugins and I'm gonna click on the plugins. Now in the plugins page, you can see at the bottom there is something called Smartslider 3. Using this slider, I created my own slider. So I'm gonna show you how. I'm gonna click on Smartslider, which is in the dashboard, and you can see I have already created my own slider. And if you want to add any pictures, you can just click on the plus icon here and you can add your pictures and then click save. Alright, now we'll go back to the Elementor, and here in the Elementor page you can see there is an option called Smart Slider. I'm just gonna drag it and place it in the page. Now it shows me which slider to include, and I'll select my slider that I have made already. So alright, my slider is available now, and let me check how does it look. It looks fantastic. I have successfully added a slider to my page, nice and sweet. And also below that I have a 3 thumbnail images for which I'm gonna link those thumbnail images to my other pages. So what do we do now? I'm just gonna include a video. So I'll include a video to my page. There is a video icon, but before that I have to add a widget, and I will add a blank widget. I'll just drag and drop my, wait a minute. Alright, I'm gonna click the plus icon in the between and I'm gonna drag and drop my video button from the Elementor. Alright, now I have to choose my video URL, and at the left top you can see there is an option for video URL. So I'm gonna quickly look into my YouTube page and I'm gonna choose my own videos URL for my page. So I'm just gonna search Sproutflowers. Third result is Sproutflowers. So I'm gonna enter my channel and I'm gonna create this video. I'm gonna choose the third one because it has more views. Alright, now I'm gonna copy the link of this video and I'm gonna paste it after deleting this video. Alright, now anytime now. Alright, now my video has been uploaded, so just a second. I'm just trying to play with it, so never mind. I'm just trying to make some changes, just to tweak a little bit how this video looks and all in my page. After I have uploaded my video, now my page looks like this. There is a slider and we have 3 thumbnail images for which I will link them later, and a video which may serve as my portfolio video in my page. So that's it. I don't like the way my page looks like at this point because I cannot add any text in the background that is not visible properly. I must change my background. This image doesn't suit my site. So I'm gonna quickly change my background image. I'm gonna go to colors and background, and I'm gonna select base. And here we are. We can remove this image and we can choose a color instead. So I'm gonna choose some color. This may take a while because I have to look at a lot of colors in order to find out. This looks somewhat good. Still not sure about the background color, guys. Maybe I can try a different kind of layout, but at this point it's impossible. Right now, let it be. Now I'm gonna just try to change my caption name. I'm gonna change the color of my caption because white looks good on orange and other colors don't. That is why. Alright, after changing all my colors, what am I gonna do? I'm gonna try changing my background color once again. Now, as you can see, my footer bar has the same color as my page. So that becomes a problem in website designing. So I'm gonna quickly customize my page and change my footer color. Black would be nice. So let me take a look. Fantastic. Now it looks just fine. After I publish this, I'm gonna go back. In case if you want a footer menu, you can always hover around to the end of the page and you can find assign footer menu at the bottom of the page. So I'm gonna click on it because I want to set up a footer menu. All right, now this brings me to this page in my dashboard, and in my footer menu options, I will use new menu. The page after asks you the name of your menu. I'm just gonna simply type as footer and I'm gonna click on create menu. Very simple. Alright, here comes the main page where I'll be asked if I want to create a dedicated menu for my footer or just link my pages that I have created. So alright, we can also add a custom URL to our footer menu, which is nice. So that's what I'm gonna do. So I'll just quickly add a custom URL. www.sprout-flowers.com, and in the link text I'm gonna type go to sproutflowers.com. All right, now it's done. Now I'm going to save my menu. Let's see how our footer looks like now. So we'll try to reload the page. And after reloading, when I hover around to the bottom, I can see a link being created. Go to sproutflowers.com. Great. This is how you do it. That is all for today, guys. Today we have learned how to change our footer URL, how to change the background, and also how to include a smart slider in our web page. So I'll meet you tomorrow. Don't forget to subscribe our channel and click the notification button to get your notifications from our channel. And also, I would appreciate if you like us on Facebook, Twitter, and Pinterest. Thanks for watching.